Cut into the flat prairie landscape, this unexpected Green River Valley with sandstone cliffs and unusual rock formations has been a favorite location for First Nations people for thousands of years. This is Writing-On-Stone Provincial Park. Writing-On-Stone is southeast of Lethbridge, Alberta, near the Montana border. Visible on the horizon are the sweetgrass hills of Montana. The Milk River actually starts in the Rockies of northern Montana, flowing north into southern Alberta here, and eventually joins the Great Mississippi River. About 1,000 years ago, at the end of the last ice age, vast volumes of water from melting glaciers carved out this valley, exposing the sandy terrain. Writing-On-Stone Park is not as well known as Alberta's Badlands, Dinosaur Provincial Park, and Drumheller, but we find more hoodoos here. A highlight is the opportunity to see the indigenous rock art and hike the Hoodoo Trail. The trail starts at the campground and proceeds west through the hoodoos for 2.2 kilometers. It's a fun hike, but be prepared for some climbing and ensure to pack proper footwear and water. The rocks with the mushroom-looking tops are called hoodoos. The dark top layer is a harder limestone, and underneath is a soft sandstone, which eventually washes away easily. This valley has been special to First Nations people for at least 3,000 years, with archaeological evidence dating back to about 1,000 BC. It's sacred to the people of the Blackfoot Nation, including the Siksika Nation of southern Alberta. They camped in the valley, hunting game, picking berries, pursuing vision quests, and recording historical events. On the rock walls are hundreds of petroglyphs spanning over 58 sites, providing the largest concentration of native rock art on the North American plains. This area became a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 2019. Most of the rock art is between 100 to 500 years old, with some possibly 1,000 years old. The most accessible and famous is the battle scene highlighted on the Hoodoo Trail. However, most of the rock art sites are only accessible by guided tour, which can be booked online in advance. We now come up towards the battle scene. It can also be reached by a short half-kilometer trail down from a parking lot on the road above. The drawing here is the most elaborate in the park, although it's somewhat hard to see. It depicts a battle on the Milk River between two tribes in 1866, showing 71 warriors in an attack on an encampment of teepees. The bullets are represented with dots and the arrows with dashes. And here is a drawing from another site. So although I didn't take a guided tour myself, I wish I did. So I strongly recommend booking one, not only to gain access to the rock art sites, but to have them meaningfully explained. If you enjoy my videos, I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified of new releases. It's free, and sharing with your friends is much appreciated.